Damian Wayne is the son of Batman and the grandson of Ra's al Ghul, a semi-immortal ninja who is the leader of the League of Assassins, and who raised Damian to be the ultimate fighter and assassin. So it comes as no surprise to anyone that Damian Wayne has done a lot of bad things. And I'm not just talking about the murders. He has done some truly twisted things in his short life, and this video is going to go over the five worst. Number 5. He let his servant be blinded. During the Year of Blood, which was a rite of passage that Ra's al Ghul had Damian undertake, in which Damian had to achieve a great number of many tasks, a lot of which involved killing people. So, needless to say, Damian did some truly despicable things during this year. But two of the worst things he did, to my mind, was 1. Wiping out the last of the Bat-Dragon species, and true, he did keep the baby alive and raise him as Goliath, but without a mate, the species will still go extinct. Although, to be fair, others may be found in the universe. But as far as Damian Wayne knows, and as far as we know, he eradicated the species. And the second was allowing his servant to be blinded. A servant who clearly loved him and practically worshipped him. Now, of course, this happened when Damian Wayne was young and was being raised by Ra's al Ghul. And he did a lot of bad things under his influence, some of which were truly disgusting. But we have to remember that he was just a child and being raised under the influence of a madman, who run a cult of ninja assassins, all of whom would die for him. So if that guy is influencing you, you're going to do some bad things. And really, how could Damian have done any better? We all would have done the same. But still, letting his servant be blinded for little to no reason, well, that's pretty bad. And though Damian clearly felt a lot of guilt for it later on, it is still a horrific thing to do to a supposed friend. Now, I would have put this higher on this list, but for 2 reasons. 1, Damian didn't actually blind him himself, he just didn't stop him from being blinded, when he easily could have. And 2, the reason he didn't say anything was out of fear of Ra's al Ghul. I mean, Ra's al Ghul terrifies everyone, even Batman is scared of him. So a small kid wouldn't really be able to stand up to him. So we can actually feel some sympathy for him, so this is in last place. Number 4, he has his own private prison below Titan's Tower. Now, the Bat family has imprisoned others before, but only in extreme circumstances, such as when Hush had surgery to look like Bruce Wayne, and they had to keep him imprisoned in private in order to protect Batman's identity. Or when they temporarily kept dangerous criminals in prison till they could safely be handed over to the authorities, such as the Joker-infected nutjobs in the Arkham Knight game. So to be fair, it's easy to see where Damian would have learned to have his own private prison. But the other Titans didn't feel the same way, and are disgusted with Damian when they learn that he's been illegally imprisoning supervillains in their basement. And in truth, I think the fact that he lied to them about it is in some ways actually worse than having the prison, and is probably what angered the other Titans so much. Now, the reason Damian has this prison is because he's tired of criminals just getting in jail and then getting out, or escaping Arkham. Basically, he wants to stop the revolving door institutions and keep the criminals locked up. Which is understandable, but still insanely illegal. And even though this is a very common comic book trope, with a lot of heroes having their own prisons, I mean, pretty much everyone in the Arrowverse has their own prison, still, it's not right, and keeping it a secret from his team is clearly crossing a line. Though after the team all found out about it, they all decided to release the criminals, but to instead mind-wash them all and give them all new, peaceful lives. Which, in many respects, is actually worse than locking them up, as they are literally stealing their identities from them. I mean, personally, I'd rather stay as me in prison than be mind-raped into becoming someone new who society prefers. And even if the criminals are happy like this, it's still incredibly wrong. And even though not all of the Titans agree with this, they all still did it, and Damian Wayne was leading the charge. And it's not the only bad thing that Damian has done to the Titans. One of the worst, in my opinion, was when he stopped Wally West's heart with a ninja attack. Now, this was to take the Speed Force powers away from Deathstroke, who'd stolen them from Kid Flash. And when they stopped his heart and killed him, it did work and reset a timeline. But it also nearly killed Wally permanently, and it was only because they were able to resuscitate him that he survived. And even so, it permanently damaged his heart, limiting how fast he could run from then on. Though since this is comic books, this won't last forever, of course, and it will eventually be fixed. But still, Damian did this without asking anyone, not even Wally. He just thought it was the fastest solution, so he stopped his heart, effectively killing one of the Titans, even though there are likely other, safer ways to accomplish their mission. And needless to say, the other Titans were extremely angry with him about this, and rightly so. Number 3. Everything with Tim Drake. Now, Damian has hated Tim Drake since the very first night they met in the Batcave, when Damian came to live with Batman. Now, this is mainly because Tim Drake is living with Batman as his adopted son, meaning that he is living the life that Damian wants, and by rights, should have. So, there's bound to be a lot of envy there. But after Damian attacks Tim, and Tim is actually winning the fight, and ends up actually having to save Damian from being attacked by the Batcave's mechanical dinosaur, Damian then sucker punches Tim and tries to kill him. So the first time that they met, he tried to kill his brother. Needless to say, it's going to be a difficult relationship from then on. And after he finds out that Tim Drake keeps a list of friends and enemies, and he finds out that he is on the enemy list, Damian loses it and beats up Tim Drake, and tries to kill him by cutting his line when he's on a stakeout, which kind of actually proves that he should be on the enemies list. Of course, this fight was broken up by Batman and didn't go too far, but still, he was trying to kill him. And after Bruce Wayne died, Damian actually takes legal action against Tim Drake to make sure he can't inherit any of Wayne Enterprises. Not that Tim wanted it or was even going to go after it, but still, Damian always has to twist the knife. He just hates the guy. And all of this is made worse by the fact that he is Damian's brother. Not by blood, but Bruce Wayne did adopt him, so they are legally brothers. And of course, they are both in the Bat family and were both Robins. So really, they should actually be quite good friends. Although, as I said, this is actually the reason for a lot of the aggression, as Damian is insanely jealous of Tim Drake and his relationship with Bruce Wayne. And more than likely, he only wants Tim Drake to care about him and actually be friends with him. But because of the way he is, he can't just say that, so instead, he acts out and does all these crazy attacks. It's nuts, I know, but this is the Bat family we're talking about, a group of people who continually dress up in costumes and beat up the mentally ill. So crazy pretty much sums them up. Number 2. All of the murders. Now, we all know that Damian is killed. As I said, he was raised an assassin. And in fact, I actually have other videos about his murders, a link to which is in this video's description. But even though we all know about them, they're still bad. Even if a lot of them were kind of justified and he was just killing supervillains. Still, they all deserve to be mentioned. But again, since Damian Wayne was born and raised in a ninja death cult, we can kind of forgive him for this a bit, because some of these actually happened when he was under the age of 10, so legally, he's not even liable for these. Yes, it is extremely bad, but it's not entirely his fault. And after all, if we'd been raised by a bunch of ninja assassins like he was raised, we probably would have done the same. And Damian has tried to stop his murderous tendencies and become a better person in more recent years. And it's only in extreme cases, for the most part, where he has killed. With that being said, there's a couple of murders that do deserve to be mentioned. One is when he killed an army of Superboy clones, which for some reason most of the Titans don't actually seem to see as murder, since they're clones, but since Superboy himself is a clone and very much a real person, I still kind of see this as murder. And he should have at least tried to bring them in without killing them. And in a possible future version of Damian Wayne's life, he has become Batman and traded his soul for superpowers, and he seems to have set out to kill all of the villains in Gotham. But again, given his origin, this isn't the worst way he could have turned out, and at least he is just killing psychopathic criminals and not innocent people. And of course, one murder that we have to mention is in the Injustice universe, when he kills Dick Grayson. Now, this was actually an accident, and Damian didn't mean to kill Dick Grayson, but even still, he did kill him, and he killed his brother. An adopted brother, yes, but still very much his brother. So it's extremely screwed up. Number 1. He took over the League of Assassins. Damian Wayne was literally created to take over the League of Assassins. This was always Ra's al Ghul's plan for him. So it isn't too surprising that he eventually accepted his destiny and took over the League of Assassins. Now, I do have to say that this didn't actually happen in the main DC universe. Instead, it happens in the future comic, Batman Beyond. And in the comic, Damian becomes, as I said, the head of the demon. But when he joined Batman and became Robin, it seemed that he was on a different path. But in the end, he turned his back on his father and the Bat family and everything they stand for and became the head of a League of Assassins that is basically just a death cult whose sole job is to kill humans to protect the Earth and its environment. And as if that wasn't bad enough, in this timeline, Damian also allows his father to be kidnapped and kept in stasis while a supervillain slowly drains his accounts of money. Now, Damian knew that his father was there, and as the head of the League of Assassins, easily could have rescued him, but Damian reasoned that as long as there was money in Bruce Wayne's accounts, then he would be kept alive. And as long as he was alive, who cares? And after all, Terry McGinnis eventually would turn up and save him, which he did. I mean, it took a few months, but what the hell, Damian figured he'd still leave his father drugged up in a coma prison and at the mercy of the head of the Joker gang. Pretty messed up, all things considered, even for the Bat family. And Christ alone knows what he ordered the League of Assassins to do when he was leader. But he is no doubt responsible for a great amount of death, blackmail, and torture. But what we do know for sure is that he made a series of missiles filled with toxins that were designed to spread a plague over the Earth and kill all but the strongest of humans, and wipe out quite a large portion of the human race. We're talking millions, if not billions, of people. Now, to be fair, in the end, he wasn't that sure about firing them, and Bruce Wayne was kind of talking him out of doing it. But he still made them, and he still had this plan, and in the end, one of his servants actually launched the missiles. And even though Batman stopped them from going off, and Damian did in turn help save Batman's life, he's still pretty responsible for an insane plan of genocide. And having a change of heart is kind of better, but it's still not good. And this is actually not only the worst thing that Damian Wayne has done, but it's actually one of the worst things that a human being has ever done. I mean, this is the kind of plan that Hitler would come up with. And of course, the worst part of all of this is that all the progress he made as a hero, all of the pacts he made with the Bat family, he just threw away and decided to become an assassin and fully embrace his arrogant, murderous, and basically evil side. This is a betrayal of the whole Bat family and everything they stand for. And that is the five worst things that Damian Wayne has done. Which one of these do you think is the worst? And are there any other things that he has done that you think should have been included? Be sure to let us know in the comments, and I'd like to say a quick thank you to those who made this video possible by donating to the Needle Mouse Productions page on Patreon. And as always, thanks for watching, and feel free to subscribe, share, like, and comment.